And Governor Brewer writing a stern letter to Secretary of State Clinton over a human rights report prepared by the State Department for the United Nations. Now, in that report, the State Department presents examples of how American law can be an example to the world and outlines ways the federal government is protecting human rights, using the Department of Justice's lawsuit against SB 1070 as an example of the government protecting human rights. As you know, some of the countries in the UN Human Rights Council are Cuba and Libya. Arizona's Governor Jan Brewer joins us. Good evening, Governor. And this letter that I have a copy of that you wrote Secretary of State Hillary Clinton dated August 27, let me read you five or six words. Simply put, it's downright offensive. Those are your words. What's downright offensive?
Well, it's absolutely nationalism gone amok. We are really offended, Greta, that the Obama administration, the Secretary Clinton would take a duly enacted law, Senate Bill 1070, and present it to the Human Rights Council at the United Nations. I believe strongly they owe us an apology and certainly want them to remove it from their report.
Now, you go on in the letter to call them hypocrites, stating that they're hypocrites because the federal government has not bothered to secure the border, which, of course, then contributes to this whole human trafficking. Go ahead.
Well, absolutely. You know, if the federal government would do their job, secure our borders, we talk about human rights. We have, thousands of illegal aliens coming across our border and suffering under inhumane conditions due to the drug cartels and due to the heat and, dying out in the middle of the desert. Doesn't have anything to do with Senate Bill 1070. It is just... It's been unbelievable how the federal government has treated the people of Arizona. And it just is something that is downright wrong. And, we just are trying to take care of our people here and get our borders secured and address the issue of the drug cartels that are coming across our border lickety-split. And this is what we get in return, you know. We heard that the government was going to sue us when she was down in Ecuador. Now we find out that they're going to turn us over to the Human Rights Council on Senate Bill 1070 and let countries like Libya and Cuba decide if we're doing right or wrong. It's outrageous. It's just outrageous and offensive, very, very offensive.
What do you mean by one of the last paragraphs? It sounds like you're threatening the federal government. It says, if you choose not to, which means if you choose not to remove SB 1070 from this report as an example of human rights violations, that the state of Arizona will monitor the proceedings and assert any rights it has in the process. And it says, be assured that the state of Arizona will fight any attempt by the United States Department of State and the United Nations to interfere with the duly enacted laws of the state of Arizona in accordance with the United States Constitution. Those sound like fighting words. What are you telling her?
Well, I'm talking to my counsel. We're not going to sit here and take it from the federal government. We are going to do whatever it is necessary to keep our sovereignty. How do you explain to these people that are doing these things that they're overstepping, they're overreaching? It's outrageous. It's very offensive, and it's wrong. Arizona has the right to enact laws that we see fit. We have sovereignty in the state of Arizona, and to refer us to a council of their making at the United Nations to have those people determine and lay us out to have Libya and Cuba determine what we are doing is wrong. So we will take whatever measures that we can do illegally and otherwise. I'm going to fight back. I can hardly get my words out, Greta. So wrong. It is so wrong that I'm breathless.
in her ongoing effort to paint the state of Arizona as somehow victimized because of the state's papers, please law. Governor Jen Brewer has conjured up a new enemy when she's going to have a hard time getting to show her its papers. It's the U.S. State Department. Foggy Bottom is on Jan Brewer's enemies list because, as part of its first ever United Nations Human Rights Council Universal Periodic Review, the State Department quietly noted that, quote, a recent Arizona law, SB 1070, has generated significant attention and debate at home and around the world. The issue is being addressed in a court action that argues that the federal government has the authority to set and enforce immigration law. That action is ongoing. Parts of the law are currently enjoined. All true. That basic statement of fact enraged the governor of Arizona, prompted her to write to Secretary of State Hillary Clinton to demand that the reference be taken out. Quote, simply put, it is downright offensive that the U.S. State Department included the state of Arizona and SB 1070 in a report to the U.N. Council on Human Rights, whose members include such renowned human rights champions, in quotes, as Cuba and Libya, as well as 45 other members like, you know, the United States, Switzerland, the United Kingdom, but hey, who's counting? Also defending your own human rights issues by bringing up Cuba and Libya because they're so much worse. I don't know. Governor Brewer then goes on to write, quote,
next gen. Yes. I do not know. I do not know what an illegal immigrant looks like. I do not know. I do not know. I do not know what an illegal immigrant looks like.
I mean, how do you answer that?
Well, Jan Brewer, the incumbent Republican, is running for re-election. She, of course, made national headlines this year by signing a very tough immigration bill into law. Last night, she faced her opposition in a televised debate, and when it was Governor Brewer's turn to deliver her opening statement in the debate, it got very awkward very quickly. Listen.
It's great to be here with Larry, Barry, and Terry, and thank you all for watching us tonight. I have done so much, and I just cannot believe that we have changed everything since I become your governor in the last 600 days. Arizona has been brought back from its abyss. We have cut the budget, we have balanced the budget, and we are moving forward. We have done everything that we could possibly do. We have did what was right for Arizona. I will tell you that I have really did the very best that anyone could do. We have pushed back hard against the federal government. We have filed suit against Obama health care, and we have passed Senate Bill 1070, and we will continue to do what's right for Arizona. I ask for your vote. Thank you.
Well, her chief opponent is the Democratic candidate, Arizona Attorney General Terry Goddard. During the debate, he repeatedly called on the governor to retract a statement she made in June where she said that Arizona police have found headless bodies in the desert. Illegal immigrants who had been beheaded, claiming increased violence along the border with Mexico. She never certified the statement. According to numerous law enforcement personnel, no beheaded bodies have ever been found in the Arizona desert, though certainly drug cartels have routinely beheaded people across the border in Mexico. During the debate, not only did the governor not retract her statement, she refused to answer her challenger and then refused to talk about it with reporters immediately after the debate. Watch.
Brewer, why wouldn't you recant the comment you've made earlier about the beheadings in the desert?
Seriously, that's a serious question, Governor.
Well, this was an interesting evening tonight.
Governor, please answer the question. About the headless bodies, why won't you recant that? Do you still believe that? Come on, Governor.
Okay, thank you.
All right, Governor, what do you mean?
Governor. Oh.
Doesn't get much more raw politics than that. Joining me now is CNN political contributor and Democratic strategist James Carville, along with Eric Erickson, also CNN contributor and editor-in-chief of RedState.com.
You got to remember as well, for perspective here, this woman was never intended to be governor. She became governor because Janet Napolitano got appointed by the president to Homeland Security. And I mean, there are a lot of people in Arizona who never really rallied around her. She kind of used SB 1070, the immigration law, to get herself into this reelection position when, in fact, behind the scenes, she opposed the law and really didn't want to sign it. I mean, chickens are coming home to roost to a degree with her. But wow, I got to be honest, this is the first time I saw the whole clip just out of sympathetic embarrassment. I didn't want to sit through it.
Yeah.
As a former campaign manager, even though I'm not pulling for her, you kind of feel sorry for whoever.
You really do.
Whoever did debate prep there, I mean, they had to. But the one point I want to say is, sure, everybody is frozen off, and I've gotten questions from you or questions from other people where I was trying to think and you couldn't get it. But that was the opening statement. Right. That was my point. Is this wasn't like you asked a question about the state budget and she was trying to think of a meeting she was in. This is like you practice this thing, I don't know, 20, 25 times before you go out.
It's kind of like asking Ted Kennedy back in 1980 why he was running for president and just couldn't really come up with an answer at the time. This is, I mean, that's kind of the basic questions and answer session that I was really surprised. At first, I thought it was a joke when I got it in email. And then to go in with the beheading question and to stand her ground on something and to ignore the press, she's going to have to deal with these issues. She's going to have to release a statement, say what was up, whether she was distracted or nervous or what have you, and deal with the headless body issue.
Well, I mean, but they're going to have to, and Eric's right, that they're going to have to answer this, so she can do a Sarah Palin and just call all the media impotent and limp, which has got to be my favorite.
Team HillaryClinton.com.